Welcome back! My name is Baller Scuba. This is Video Games Over Time! We are still in 1985. Today, we're going to talk about Tekken World Cup. The story of Tekken World Cup takes us to Tekken. Tekken is a Japanese video game developer founded in 1967 by Yoshihito Kakihara. It formed as a merger between Imperial Trustee Corporation and Nippon Yacht Corporation, companies that sold amusement equipment and the real estate of ships. Tekken would start selling video games in 1981, starting with a shooter named Pleiades. Tekken would continue to release arcade games throughout the early 80s. The most successful of these would be Gridiron Fight, which we talked about in an honorable mentions video this year. For Tekken World Cup, Tekken turned to Shinichiro Tomie, who had created Gridiron Fight. Tomie was helped by Kazutoshi Ueda and Michishito Ishizuka. Rei Ishizuka and Hideyuki Yokoyama would provide art for the game, and Tsukasa Masuko would provide sound for the game. Tomie was inspired by his love of soccer and the manga Captain Tsubasa to create a soccer game similar to Gridiron Fight. Tomie wanted to use the trackball controls from Gridiron Fight with simpler controls for the new soccer game. Tekken World Cup is a soccer sports game. Players can play either against the computer or against each other. The game has a two-dimensional bird's-eye view perspective of the action on the field, scrolling in multiple directions. There is only one button along with the trackball for shooting. The trackball will control both the direction and speed of the shot. Tekken released Tekken World Cup in November 1985 to Japanese arcades. This was followed by a worldwide arcade release in January 1986. That is a brief backstory to Tekken World Cup. With that told, it's time to play the game for ourselves. And here we are in the game. This is Tekken World Cup. As you can see, copyright 1985, Tekken Limited, all rights reserved, just the one right. But we do have a list of best players. I should be able to make that list. You only have to get to the fourth game to pretty much be at the top. But it is the World Football Championship of Tekken. And then we get into the game. This is soccer. It's a very simplified version of soccer if you are unfamiliar with the sport. We talked about it a bit in our last video, just a brief introduction. Really, when it comes to soccer video games, there's not really a lot to talk about because it is kind of fairly simple and you don't have to worry about things like handballs and did I tackle too hard in a lot of video games, especially this one. This is also a simplified version. We could sit here and watch the demo play this whole time. I think it's better just to get into the game. But the general idea is kick the ball. We need to go up. They need to go down, get it in the goal, get it past the goalie. That's pretty much it. Let's see what we can do. Now, I don't have a trackball. I have a joystick. And we're going to be the red team up against the kind of dark blue team. Let's say it's England versus France. That makes sense to me. Because I have the joystick, I have more control, but a little bit less power. I'm also good at the game. I have been practicing. Not too hard, but a little bit. There are certain spots I know I can stand that will always score a goal. That's one of them. The goalie just can't figure out what to do in that situation. So, I'm not going to pretend I don't know that. Just playing the game for more than like 20, 30 seconds and you'll pretty much figure out the same thing. It's not hard to figure this out. The goalie will get better as we keep going, but there's no reason for me to just, you know, not do this. kicking straight usually doesn't do a lot for you. You know, just kind of hang out there and boom, there you go. I've never done this well, though, to be honest. They are not playing very well. Oh, the glitching has started. That happens sometimes. All right, so 30 seconds have elapsed. That's what that little jingle was. What is happening? It's not just me, right? The game is, like, glitching. What happened? What is happening? All right, let's get my goal back. There we go. Usually I don't give up a goal, especially on the first game, but something was going on. My players were just kind of glitching away. I don't know why the ball goes through the net either. But hopefully I can kind of keep this up and score again. You're not supposed to score 9 goals in a soccer game. And you're especially not supposed to just steal the ball, dribble all the way over, get... No! Oh, I did go... I finally got a pass. I don't pass too often in this game. All right. Corner kick. And... Goal! Sliding in. It wasn't even me. The AI did it. Double digits. We're up to 10 goals. That never happens in soccer. Usually it's like 1-0 or like maybe 2-1, 2-0, something like that. Not 10-1, 11-1. That never happens. Sure we're playing the right kind of football? Alright, there we go, and... Huh. Yeah, it's like just inside the penalty area, right around the edge of the net. That'll do it for you. Alright, 3, and... Huh. Nope. Ugh. There's time. I went for it when the goalie had it. Alright, so England up against all white? Germany? Germany has colors like that sometimes? At least similar to that. Yeah, I don't pass often. It's easier to just run and shoot. And I like hanging out on the left side and kicking right, but I could easily go the other way too. Oh, off the goal. No, they cleared it. How could they? And now my players aren't glitching anymore. That's always nice. It happened to me a couple times while I was doing it. This time wasn't the worst that I've seen, but it was still bad. Still cost me a goal. And there's a little glitch for you. The goalie is just not prepared for me. You would think eventually they would figure out, like, I can't shoot straight from there. I'm gonna shoot at a 45 degree angle. And it's just gonna hit the other corner of the net. All right, we'll go this way. Yep, same thing. Those are the best spots in the game. There we go. Now, of course, this would be a lot more fun with friends. Because, like I said, I haven't been practicing too much. I've probably played it maybe like 5 minutes before I picked this up and started recording. And it's just, it's easy to figure out because it's simple. It's a simple game. Soccer is fairly straightforward. There's a lot of complexity in the nuance of it, but, you know, video games in 1985, not necessarily big on nuance. Especially arcade games. All right. There we go. Get double digits again. At some point, my team should stop celebrating. It's kind of bad manners to have the full celebration for goal number 10, you know? And there we go. Nope, we all have to do like the airplane. The airplane celebration, arms out. I got one more in me. You can see the goalie's getting a little bit better. Still not good. Not enough to stop me, but we'll see what we can do. All right. No, I wanted to kick it from there. They stole it from me, though. I wanted to get in the middle. All right, let's say this is England versus Brazil. That's very classic Brazilian outfit. Yeah, all of a sudden the team is a lot better. Yeah. I haven't been able to beat the fourth team yet. Just this huge markup in quality of the team. The opponent is so much harder. By the way, I haven't figured out how to tackle, right? There's only one button. So you would think that I'd be able to figure out how to tackle. Haven't figured it out in this one, though. All right, so we're tied now. Maybe I can... this is the third game, but... Yeah, I think I've been able to beat the third team before, but that level increase, that difficulty increase from game two to game three is huge. There we go. Gives me a little bit of a buffer. I should be able to win this and beat the Brazilians. Brazil's got a really good team, like most years. There we go. England? Eh, not always. I don't know. I'm not a huge soccer history buff, but I do know, like, Brazil. Like, oh yeah, Brazil, they're good. I kicked it too far. I wanted to pass it, but because I have, like, the trackball basically going full tilt, it doesn't always work well for passing. There we go. Had a little bit of trouble to start, but we kind of got into a groove. Not as good as some of the other matches we've had. We'll stay in single digits. But we'll definitely score quite a few goals. All right. Get up here. And once you get, like, on the offensive side, like, you really start speeding up. Like, you're slow on defense and then really fast on offense. It doesn't always make all the sense in the world. I kick to the side. Yeah, you would think with, like, a trackball, and maybe it's just the controls that I'm on. That was a hell of a score. That was nicely done. That I'd have a little bit more nuance in where I can kick it, like, all these different angles. And yeah, it looks like the teams are just looping, right? That's similar to the first team again. Looks like it's France. France usually wears blue, right? No! Yeah, I haven't been able to beat these guys yet. But there we go, got a goal. It's very fast paced. You'll hear me be just quiet all of a sudden. That's because I have to concentrate. Where did my defense go? Defense, please. No, you can go the whole way, dude. You got it. No, goalie got it. Goalie never gets that. That would have been a goal for all three other games. Okay. Huh. Yep, he was able to get there and stop it. Where did my defender go? Now's not the time to be glitching. Yeah, I gotta get closer. Goalie's too good. Nerf goalie. No! Also, like, penalty, like, goal kicks, they usually end up in the other team's hands. Like, more often than you actually get the ball yourself. They end up with your opponent. All right, 20 seconds. I'm still up 1-0, so things are going all right for me. Just pass it and no! They cleared it. All right, as long as I keep them out of the goal for, you know, like 3 seconds. Okay, we win! All right, fifth game. We're up against, I don't know, Russia maybe? Czechoslovakia? Hey, there we go. Goalie didn't get that one. The defense was a lot better last time, on top of the goalie being good. There we go. Getting back into the groove of things. I easily have the high score because I got to the fifth game. But yeah, that was my first time beating the fourth team. I will take it. Speaking of taking, give me the ball. There, I got it. And there. Too far out. Goalie's good. This could also be Korea. They wear similar patterns. All right, they get a corner kick, but you know, everybody's blonde. Jeez. Was that a bicycle kick? I don't know how to do any of that. I know this strategy. Ah! That guy on the other side should have gotten it. What? I swear my guy had it and then disappeared. And then they had it again. Where was my goalie? I don't think we're gonna be able to win this one. The game's glitching on me again. I can't get the goals. There we go. It's all about finding that little sweet spot. Literally a spot. Okay, what? Okay, now I have the ball up here. Sure, I'll take it. No! How dare you stop me from scoring every time I get the ball. Did my guy tackle my other guy? Or did he disappear? No! Alright, we're still ahead. But I got an extra one. There we go. Oh, time up. All right, we win again. Sixth game. I don't recognize anybody that would have that outfit. Don't know. That doesn't look familiar at all to me. Get it? No! I have to actually use strategy? How dare you? What? Why do you kick it so high? Alright. Get it. Go. I might actually have to start passing. I've never been good at that because it means I have to... Ugh. Alright. I played as the goalie and I got it. Yeah, like I said, goal kicks, they almost always end up going to the opponent. Not in real soccer, in this game. No, they stopped me. All right, corner kick. Huh. No, you missed it. Yeah, like I can't do a soft kick is one of the issues. I have to like stop running to do the soft kick so I can pass. And then, my guy just stood still. Like, half my guys are just staying still here. Alright, still 0-0. Looks like this is gonna be the end for me. Why'd you go for, like, a pass? Like, way out of bounds. Why didn't you go... Alright, ugh. Yeah, it wasn't... I'll take it, though. Look at those scores. Those are insane. All right. And... apparently this trackball is very sensitive. There we go! Get my name in there. And that is the game. That is Tekken World Cup. Simple, yes, but it's good. And with the gameplay, it's time to talk about how it holds up today. Playing the game today, I did have fun playing Tekken World Cup. It is fairly simple and straightforward, so I can't see playing this for a long period of time, but for, you know, like 20 minutes, half hour, sure, I had fun playing the game. It is simple and therefore is good for just picking up and playing. You don't really need to go in with a set strategy. You can kind of figure out something that works for you as you go along. Like I said, in 5 minutes, I was able to figure out a strategy that let me win 13-1 against my opponents, and that's with the game sometimes glitching on me. And that did happen quite a few times, the glitching. So I have to assume that there's some programming with the original game that was causing that, but it could just be the way that I'm playing it now is causing those issues. So I'll try not to hold that too much against it. But, you know, other than that, there's not really a lot to talk about with this game. It would be a lot more fun with friends, I could tell you that, with one-on-one, trying to figure out how to stop your opponent's strategy, especially when you know what they're going to do, like my opponent should have known what I was going to do. That would be more fun. Going against the computer, though, still fun. In terms of how well it holds up, obviously there are better soccer games out there. This one is not the best soccer game of all time. It is good though. It's straightforward. It does what it deliver. It does deliver what it promises, is what I mean to say. It is decent. It's good, I would say. The graphics look good. It looks like you're on a soccer field. It's a little weird that you're doing it from a top-down perspective, but that has to do with the limitations of the time, and, you know, it works. I would like to see more of the field. I would like to see easier controls, especially when it comes to passing. I would like passing to be a separate button than shooting. I would like a tackle button, right? I can hit the button and chase the opponent all I want, but the guy never slides or tackles. Maybe I'm not doing the exact thing that I need to do to tackle, but honestly, tackle should just be a button. I would love shoot and pass to be two different ones. That way, you know, when I'm going for a longer shot, I don't just like kick it into the stands. But ultimately, the game is fun. The graphics hold up. The gameplay is relatively fun. Like I said, it's very simplistic. I would like more controls there of everything. That's the part that aged the worst, is just the control scheme of the game. Sound is good. Nice little jingles. Nothing too annoying that we have seen in the past. Nothing spectacular or anything like that, but they're good. So the graphics, sound, hold up, gameplay's good. Ultimately, this is a game that is a bit of fun for short periods of time. So in terms of recommending it to a modern audience, it really is just kind of more of a novelty, seeing what a sports game from 1985 looks like, seeing what early soccer games look like. But ultimately, it's one that could also be skipped. But I would recommend it. Just, you know, put a quarter in, see how far you can make it. You'll have some fun. It's not like it's a frustrating game unless you actually start injuring yourself on trackballs like I sometimes do. But if you can avoid that, you'll have fun playing the game. But it's also one that probably is easily skipped if you're short on time or, you know, only want to play a select few amount of games. But ultimately, check it out. And that's my modern take on the game. When the game was released, Tekken World Cup would be successful. It would be one of the best-selling arcade cabinets of 1986 and 1987 in Japan. Critics at the time were also positive about the game, particularly citing the graphics and controls as highlights of the game. Tekken World Cup would prove to be influential on soccer games. The trackball system, its perspective, and its physics were seen as revolutionary and would be copied by later games. It would receive a sequel and ports. We will keep an eye on these as we continue. As for Tekken, their most successful game to date would keep the company creating video games. We will hear from Tekken again in the future. As for Shinichiro Tomie, he would also continue to create video games. We will hear from Shinichiro Tomie as we continue as well. That will do it for the story of Tekken World Cup for now. My name is Baller Scuba. This has been Video Games Over Time. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in our next video when we try to be virtuous. Thank you.